गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम इन कंप्यूटर क्लास ऑफ 8th स्टैंडर्ड एंड वी आर डूइंग चैप्टर नंबर 3 चार्ट्स इन एक्सेल। इन आर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव लर्नड व्हाट इज अ चार्ट एंड डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ चार्ट। सो इन टुडेज क्लास वी विल लर्न डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ चार्ट, हाउ टू चेंज चार्ट टाइप, स्पार्क लाइन्स एंड कॉम्बो चार्ट। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ चार्ट। फर्स्ट चार्ट टाइप इज बार चार्ट। बार चार्ट डिस्प्लेस डेटा इन द फॉर्म ऑफ लॉन्ग रेक्टेंगुलर रॉड्स लाइक यू कैन सी इन दिस पिक्चर एंड दीज रॉड्स आर कॉल्ड बार्स। दीज बार्स आर प्लेस्ड वर्टिकली और हॉरिजॉन्टली ऑन द चार्ट एरिया। Next type is column chart. Column chart is the default chart type of MS Excel. It is quite easy to understand. A column chart is a commonly used chart type to display the data in the form of vertical bars. Like you can see in this chart, these are the vertical bars. So this is a column chart. Next is line chart. Line chart is in the form of lines. It is similar to plotting a graph on a paper. Line chart is used to track changes for the short and long period of time. Suppose if you need to analyze how the revenue of your company developed in a year, then you can use line chart. This chart is also used to represent huge amount of data. Next type is area chart. An area chart is a line chart with the areas below the lines filled with color. Now you can see in this chart some area is filled with blue color. So this type of chart is called an area chart. Area chart emphasizes on the volume of changes over time. Next type is scatter chart. Scatter chart is also called XY chart. A scatter chart works best when we will compare large number of data without regard to time. This is a very powerful type of chart and good when you are trying to show the relationship between two variables x and y axis. Next type is pie chart. Pie chart displays data in the form of circle that is divided into series of segments like you can see in this graph, and these segments show the relative size of each item in the chart. Like here, this blue color of the chart shows the marks of Kabir. This chart type works best with smaller number of values. Next type is donut chart. Like this is a donut chart. Just like a pie chart, a donut chart also displays data as a sections of a circle, but it can have more than one data series. Each data series adds a ring to the chart. Like you can see in this chart, the data chart in form of rings. Next type of chart is stock chart. As the name indicates, this chart is useful to show the fluctuation in stock prices. It has been designed specifically for the plotting data values related to stocks. These charts are useful to show fluctuations in other data also, such as daily rainfall and annual temperature. Next type is radar chart. This chart looks similar to a spider net. It displays data values plotted as points which are connected by lines to form a grid. This chart is useful for comparing data that is not time dependent but shows different circumstances. Like, you can see how the overall performance of two employees is compared using a spider graph. You can see in this graph, to compare them, we have used variables like punctuality, communication skills, technology knowledge, teamwork, etc. So radar chart is used to comparing two values. Next chart is bubble chart. For bubble chart, we have to arrange our data in columns on a worksheet. It generally displays three dimensions of data in form of disk plotted on XY graph. Two values are represented by the XY location of the disk and third value is depicted by its size, as you can see in this bubble graph. Next type is surface chart. You can use a surface chart when both categories and data series are numeric values. It is useful when you want to find optimum combination between two sets of data. Like you can see in this chart, this is a surface chart. Next is sparklines. Sparklines mini charts that fit into a single worksheet cell to provide the visual representation of the data. Like you can see here, I have plotted one chart in a single cell. So this is a sparklines chart. Now there are three types of sparklines. Number one is a line. Number two is a column. Number three is a win loss. Next chart type is combo chart. A combo chart is a combination of two or more chart types in a single unit. As you can see in this chart is a combination of column chart and line chart. This chart is very useful when we are comparing values in different categories. Next is steps to change chart type. Means if you want to change your chart style, then you can change it by using these steps. So I'll show you how to change chart type. So now I'm going to open Excel 2016. So the steps are click on start button, click on Excel 2016. Now the Excel window will appear on your screen. And here you can see that I have already inserted one chart related with students' report. So I want to change this chart type. So the second step is right click on the chart. Click on change chart type. Select any sub chart type. And then click on OK. So this is the way to change the chart type. One more method is there to change this chart type, that is select the chart. It is already selected. Then click on design tab. Then click on change chart type. You can see this is change chart type. Click on it and then select any sub chart type and then click on OK. So this is the second method to change chart type. So these are the steps to change chart type. Number one, right click on the chart. Number two, click on the change chart type option. Number three, select any sub chart type. Then click on OK. This is all about of today's class. Here you have learned different types of chart, how to change chart type, sparklines and combo chart. So students, read this chapter and learn these types of chart at home. Thank you.